Jack Frost nipping at your nose. Yuletide carols being sung by a choir. Folks dressed up like Eskimos. Everybody knows turkey and mistletoes. It helps to make the season bright. Tiny tots with their eyes all aglow, we'll find it hard to sleep tonight. They know that Santa's on his way. He's loaded lots of toys and goodies on his sleigh. Many times, many ways, Merry Christmas, Merry Christmas, Merry Christmas to
cool and everything. Everybody likes to sing about Santa Claus and reindeers and snowmen, but we must always remember that Jesus Christ is the reason for this season. Family, would y'all agree with me tonight? Where my family at? Come on. We came to celebrate the Savior. Come on. Come on. Come on. Come on. Come on. Simply said,
Jesus the same, yesterday, today, and forevermore. No other name that can save, deliver, and restore. Oh, Jesus the same, yesterday, today, and forevermore.
Say,
faithful,
powerful, That's how you do it. That's how you celebrate Christmas. Come on, somebody. Come on, come on. That's what we came to do on tonight. That's what we came to do on tonight. Amen. What you got to say, Sister Trish?
Look, hey, y'all. Did y'all ever think about there's really no other name like our God?
Amen. Amen. And you know, he is so worthy of all of our praise.
Thank you.
For you deserve the praise. Worthy is your name. Worthy is your name, Jesus. For you deserve the praise. Worthy is your name. Everybody say,
goodness, Gary, you really took us in on that one.
Well, you know, I had to let the Holy Ghost come on in, you know.
Amen.
The Holy Ghost have his way.
I know that's right. Thank you, Lord.
Do y'all know why this is my favorite time of the year?
Why?
Because I get to sing all my favorite Christmas songs.
Okay. I feel you. Christmas songs are really good. You know what? I got one. I got one that's really good. It Take the Cake for all the rest of them. Y'all going to sing it with me? Y'all going to sing it? No, y'all got the head. Y'all got it. Elder, Rashad, could you put me in G, please? Okay.
All night divine.
pray, for each man is our brother, and in his name all oppression will cease. In grateful chorus raise we.
Uh-oh. Y'all listen to this.
Watch y'all share.
See if you know it.
Mary, did
creation. Did you know that your baby boy will one day rule the nation? Did you know that your baby boy is heaven's perfect lamb? And the sleeping child you're holding is the great I am. Mary, oh Mary, did you know, did you know, did you know, did you know that you were carrying the King of Kings? He was the Savior of the world. Oh, oh, Mary, did you know?
Yeah, that's one of my favorites.
You guys, these songs bring back so many Christmas memories.
Yeah, Z. Do you remember that old Kirk Franklin song we used to sing?
The night that Christ was born? Is that it? Oh, guess what? And guess what? Gary can be Kirk Franklin.
Hold up.
Yes, that's
hold up now. Now, y'all play too much.
Yeah.
Well, go on here,
come
then.
On. Come on.
Fine.
We need you. Come on.
I want to say, listen to the angels.
Listen to the angels rejoicing ever so sweetly, receiving heaven's glory the night that Christ was born.
Can't you see the people?
Can't you see the people coming from every nation, pleading for salvation, the night that Christ was born? Ooh. Oh, 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 oh. The night that Christ
was born. Come on and sing it for us, Sister Z.
Leading
like that
yes.
one.
Yes. Y'all, these are some powerful songs.
They are.
Y'all ever wonder if Joseph and Mary really knew the miracle that took place that night?
Yeah, that's a good question, yeah.
Man, what's up, y'all? What y'all got going on here? What's up? What's up?
We were just discussing the night that Christ was born, and actually it was a miracle in a manger.
Man, what y'all know about the miracle in the manger? Well, since I'm a preacher and I'm always prepared, I'll go ahead and drop some nuggets on y'all. Y'all got time?
All right.
Luke chapter 2. Verse number 7, it literally gives us a large description of what the miracle in the manger really means. And so as we read Luke chapter 2, verse number 7 together, this is what it says. It says, check this out. It says, and she gave birth to her firstborn son and wrapped him in swaddling clothes and laid him in the manger because there was no place for them in the inn. And so up under this theme, miracle in the manger, I want to talk just a few moments from these words, the messy miracle. The messy miracle. There's a guy that was living in the city of Oklahoma. So he's living in the city of Oklahoma, and he's doing some crazy, extraordinary stuff. He goes and he purchases 56 exotic animals. Yeah, that's pretty crazy. And so he's sitting in his living room with all 56 exotic animals. And one day he decides to open all of the cages of all 56 animals. Then he goes, gets his gun, sits down, and he commits suicide. So now you have 56 exotic animals roaming, literally roaming and running around the city of Oklahoma. And so now the people in the city have now had to call the city officials, police department, fire rescue, and people that can come and literally tame these animals. And so they were able to capture 55 of the animals, but there was one animal that they couldn't capture, and it was an infected monkey. And so now you have an infected monkey running around the city of Oklahoma, running rapidly, spreading infection. I already know what you're saying. I know. Don't panic. I know what you're saying. Pastor Trey, what in the world does an infected monkey, a man that commits suicide, have to do with anything? I'm so very glad you asked, because here it is, that the body of Christ has what I call a heavy infection. And that infection is in the fact that we don't understand the significance of the miracle in the manger. The miracle in the manger is not just an ordinary miracle in the manger. It's an extraordinary miracle in the manger. And in the words of Dr. Will Joshua, he helped me to understand that it's not, this season is not just about presence, but it's about his presence.
Right.
Man,
right.
Did y'all hear what I just said? Yes, it's not about presence, yes, or just about presence, but it's about his presence.
Yes,
in his presence, there is the fullness of joy.
That's right.
There is life forevermore.
That's right.
And so real quickly, there's a few things that the miracle in the manger teaches us. Few things the miracle in the manger teaches us. Number one, I hope y'all ready for this. The first thing that the miracle in the manger teaches us, I almost shouted off this, y'all. Number one is it's not about the place you're born, but about the plan and purpose for your life. Now, it has nothing to do with the place you're born. If you look at the text, look at verse number 7. It says, and she gave birth to her firstborn and wrapped him in swaddling clothes and laid him in a manger because there was no place for them in the inn. The Jews thought that Jesus was going to be born in luxury. They thought that Jesus was going to be born in royalty. But no, no, no. God had another masterful plan. And he was not born in royalty. No, no. He was born in what we call a stinking place. What does the manger represent? The manger represents a dark place. It not only represents a dark place, it represents a dirty, nasty, stinking place. Yeah. And it helps us to understand that comfort never met Christ. Oh, my God. The Jews thought that Christ would literally be born in luxury and royalty. But no, God had a whole nother plan. And that helps us to understand that we should never limit God by our expectations. Because understand that God is at work wherever, even in the most dirty and darkest places of our lives. Did y'all hear what I just said? He's at work even in the most dirty and darkest places of our life. So the first thing that the miracle in the manger teaches us, number one, is that it's not about the place you're born, but it's about the plan and purpose for your life. You got to understand, all of us have been born in some crazy situations. But guess what? No matter how crazy our situations were, guess what? We are still walking miracles. And so number one, it's not about the place you're born, but about the plan and purpose for your life. But here's number two. The second thing we learn about the miracle in the manger is in the fact that the miracle set the foundation for more miracles. Listen, I don't know about you. I'm a miracle. You're a miracle. Everybody's a miracle. This miracle brought joy to the world. Not only joy, but it brought peace. But I see joy in a whole, or from a whole nother perspective, because if you look at the word joy, it's an acronym. The J means Jesus, the O means others, and the Y means yourself. And if you live life in that order, you can have what I call true joy. Yeah, this miracle brought joy. This miracle, watch this, set us up for the miracle of salvation. Man, you got to get this. If Christ is not born, there's no chance for us to be born again.
That's right.
Did y'all hear what I just
said?
If Christ is not, I said I wasn't going to get happy. If Christ is not born, there's no room for us or no chance for us to be born again.
Yes, sir.
Christ was born, but we can't leave him in the manger. Because, understand, he was a baby, but this baby lived an amazing life.
Yes.
He died for us, then he ascended into heaven, and he will come back soon.
Yes.
So here's the question that's on the table. Do you still picture Jesus as a baby in the manger? Or is he your Lord? Make sure, and I mean make absolutely sure, you never underestimate Jesus and just look at him as a baby, but you got to let him grow up in your life. Number one, the miracle in the manger teaches us that it's not about the place you were born, but it's about the plan and the purpose that God has for your life. Number two, it helps us to understand that the miracle set the foundation for more. But here's the last thing that the miracle in the manger teaches us, and I'm out of here. Last thing that the miracle in the manger teaches us is that the birth was not the miracle, but the conception was the miracle. I don't think y'all got that. Listen. The birth was not the miracle, but the conception was really the miracle. Christ was not conceived through sex or sin, but it was a spiritual birth. Lord, even though Christ was born in a dirty place, he came out clean because of how he was conceived. If you think about all of the people that were born through unmarital sex, that were born in some dark places, born after the club. Some people that were born after some of those love songs. But no, Jesus' birth was a clean birth. And understand, even though some of us may have been born in some dirty situations, guess what? Even though we are a mess, guess what, y'all? You got to get this. We are a messy miracle. Listen, I don't know about you, but I know I'm a mess. I know I'm tore up, jacked up from the flow up. But guess what? God loves me. And if it had not been for a Savior that was born, but not only, I can't leave him there. I got to take him to the cross. He died for us. And that's why I'm happy. That's why I'm glad I'm saved. Is there anybody in here that knows what I'm talking about? That you're glad for the miracle in the manger, that the miracle in the manger changed the trajectory of your life. That's why I get excited about the miracle in the manger. But I'm going to leave you on this story here. Story's told of a young boy. And I promise you I'm done. Story's told of a young boy who just got through opening up his Christmas presents. He goes outside. He's sitting on the steps after he's opened up all his gifts, and he starts eating a bunch of candy. An old man walks by. He says, "Son, do you not understand that if you keep eating that candy, all of your teeth are going to fall out?" The young boy respectfully responds to the old man. He says, "Sir, I don't mean to disrespect you, but my grandfather lived 102 to see 102 years old." The old man responded. He said, "Well, son, did he live to see 102 years old by eating candy?" He says, no. He said he lived to see 102 years old by minding his business. Boy, I came to let somebody know tonight. I'm just like the little boy. I'm minding my business. I'm minding my own mess, staying out of other people's mess. Why? Because I'm a messy miracle myself. Is there anybody here that can say that you know you a mess, that you know that you a miracle? See, somebody ought to shout hallelujah. Somebody ought to shout glory. Somebody ought to give God glory, because not only am I a mess, but I'm a messy miracle. I'm excited tonight to know that a Savior's been born. I'm excited tonight to know that Jesus, not only was he born, but he died. But early one Sunday morning, boy, I said I wasn't going to do this. He got up with all power. Man, where that organ at? He got up with all power in his hands. I'm done.
My God. Well, y'all ready to sing some more?
Bread of life, sent down from glory, many things you were.
Many things you are on earth, a holy king.
Praise the name of Jesus. Well, praise team, I had a great time tonight. I don't know about y'all, but I had a wonderful time. And I know we sung a lot of songs, but hey, we got to give all of our best to Jesus. And listen, to all of you tuning in tonight, if you do not know Jesus Christ as Lord and Savior, you need to get to know him now. Trust me, he will make you whole. He will save your soul. This is the reason for, he is the reason for this season. So if you don't know him, it's best that you get to know him on tonight. Amen. Listen, before we end, we got one more song for y'all. We got one more song for y'all. One more. One more. Can we have a little fun? Can we have a little fun? All right. Come on. Song says,
hang on a mistletoe, I'm gonna get to know you better. This Christmas, and as we trim the tree, how much fun it's gonna be together. This Christmas, the fireside is blazing bright. We're caroling through the night. And this Christmas will be a very special Christmas for me, yeah.
Come on, say y'all.
Shake a hand, shake a hand.
Second verse says,
presents and cars are here. My world is filled with cheer in you. This Christmas, and as I look around, your love is shining down through you. Oh, yes, it is. This Christmas, the fireside is blazing bright. We're caroling.
You were blessed on tonight. Remember, Jesus is the reason for the season. We love you, Hopewell Church.